Hi, this is a video on testing deductive arguments using Venn diagrams. And if you need this worksheet, you can go to my website at caroleemath.com. We have three examples here. So let's go through each one. Now, these examples, we're going to be using some concepts from previous videos. So feel free to go back and review those if you want to. One thing we're going to be using is representing premises with a Venn diagram. And then the other thing we're going to be using is looking at deductive arguments. So there's two separate videos for those if you want to go back and refresh those. Okay, let's look at example one. We have two premises and a conclusion. The first premise says all narcotics are habit forming. We're not worried yet about whether these things are true or false. We just want to represent them in a visual way, which is going to help us determine if the argument is valid. Okay, all narcotics are habit forming. All, remember that one's a subset, or you can just sort of think about it. All means one is inside the other. So the word all is a key word for subset. And then we need to figure out which is the bigger set. So I'm going to draw a big set. Which is the bigger set, narcotics or things that are habit forming? The things that are habit forming, there are more things that are habit forming than just narcotics. So things that are habit forming. Watching TV, gambling, lots of things are habit forming. Alcohol, narcotics is one thing that can be. Or, and according to this, are narcotics, all narcotics are habit forming. So narcotics is a subset of things that are habit forming. That's our first premise. Now our second premise is aspirin is not habit forming. Okay, aspirin is another item. This is a new premise. Where would aspirin go? In this circle, it's saying aspirin is not habit-forming, and this circle is things that are habit-forming. So aspirin needs to go outside, and I'm going to label that with an X, because that's one specific thing. So aspirin is out here. Now let's look at our conclusion. It says aspirin is not a narcotic. So does this fit our picture? Aspirin is not in the narcotic circle, so this is a valid argument. It's valid because our conclusion follows from the two premises. And we haven't said whether this is true or false yet. That has to do with whether the conclusion is sound. So let's go back and look at whether each one is true or false. So the premise all narcotics are habit forming, is that true? I looked it up. It is true. Aspirin is not habit forming. Is that true? I also looked that up. It is. It can be when it's combined with other medications that are habit forming, like narcotics, but aspirin by itself is not habit forming. So our premises are true, and we have a valid argument or a valid conclusion. So this conclusion is sound. So we can take some complicated statements, and I'm a visual learner, and if you're visual, it can really help to draw this out. Okay, let's go to the second one. Example two. The first premise is no country is an island. Again, we're not looking at whether it's true or false just yet. We are just visually representing this premise. No country is an island. So that word no, do you know what that's a keyword for? Disjoint. That means no country, if no country is an island, those are disjoint sets. So I'm going to draw two separate disjoint sets. So we would have countries over here and islands over here, according to this premise, that no country is an island. Okay, let's go to our second premise. Iceland is a country. So Iceland is a country, where would Iceland go? According to the premise, Iceland is a country, so it would go here. So I'll put an X. That's our second premise. And our conclusion, let's see if it follows, if it's valid. Iceland is not an island. According to our diagram, Iceland is not an island. So this is a valid argument, a valid deductive argument. Now you might be scratching your head saying, but Iceland is a country, so what's wrong with this? Let's go back to see if this is sound or not sound. So no country is an island, is that true? No, that's totally false. There's a lot of countries that are islands. Australia, Japan, Cuba, Great Britain, there's a ton of them. Ton of countries that are islands. Madagascar, list them all. Iceland is a country, is that true? Yes, that is true. But it doesn't really matter because our first premise is false. So this cannot be a sound argument. And of course, you know that Iceland is an island. This is not sound. So our conclusion actually is false. Okay, so there's an example of an argument where the conclusion is valid but not sound. And let's do one more. Testing a conditional deductive argument. Remember, conditional is the if-then statement. So sometimes you'll see those in your premises. If an employee is regularly late, then the employee will be fired. So this is a conditional premise. If an employee is regularly late, then the employee will be fired. So how can we visualize this? Would it be a subset, overlapping, or disjoint? If an employee is regularly late, then the employee will be fired. So if this is true, the second part is true. So that means this is a subset. So if then is always going to be a subset. And then the trick is figuring out which is the bigger set and which is the smaller set. Which is the bigger set? If they're late, then they have to be fired according to this. So that means late is the smaller set. If they're late, then they will be in this set. Sorry, regularly late. Then they will be in this set, which is fired. I know some jobs it only takes once, but this one says regularly late. Okay, so we've got the if-then. If an employee is regularly late, then they will be fired. That visual matches our premise. The second premise is Sharon was fired. So where is Sharon in this diagram? She's not out here because she was fired, but this is also fired because it's inside the circle. So we don't know from these two premises, we don't know if Sharon is in this part of fired or this part of fired. And so what we do is we put the X right on the edge, right on the border, because we don't know where she is. So we'll put Sharon. So what that means is we can, let me read the conclusion first. Sharon was regularly late. That means we don't know if she was regularly late or not. We do know she was fired. We don't know why. Could have been a different reason. So this is an invalid conclusion. We cannot conclude from these two premises that she was regularly late. If the X had been inside, then it would be a valid argument. And if it's invalid, can it be sound? No, there's no way that an invalid argument can be sound. So this is not sound. It doesn't matter if these are true or false. There's no way to conclude this from these two statements. So that gives you three examples of how to draw Venn diagrams. And we have one example that's valid and sound, one example that's valid but not sound, and then one example that's invalid and not sound. Now there's, depending on your premises, the pictures may look different, but you can follow through the reasoning on each one and determine whether each argument is valid and sound. All right, thanks for watching this video, and I'll see you on the next one.